Welcome to SciTech AI Utopia. Today we are going to talk about tachyons. Yes, the hypothetical particles capable of traveling faster than the speed of light. A bit later we will discuss how the existence of tachyons could have influenced the universe. Tachyons have the remarkable property of accelerating as they lose energy. In a reversal of common physics, when tachyons lose energy, they travel even faster. And if they were to lose all their energy, they would theoretically attain infinite velocity. Conversely, when tachyons gain energy, they slow down until they reach the speed of light. One of the most distinctive characteristics of tachyons is their imaginary mass, represented by square root of minus 1, denoted as I. This seemingly abstract concept in the context of Einstein's famous equation E equals mc square leads to a profound consequence. When m is replaced with im, particles acquire the potential to travel faster than light. Let us now talk about tachyons' interaction with matter. Energy loss through collisions. As tachyons traverse through matter, they engage in collisions with atoms, resulting in energy loss. This interaction appears to be a familiar concept, akin to particles slowing down upon colliding with a medium. Paradoxical energy gain. However, the paradoxical aspect of tachyons becomes evident as energy loss leads to acceleration, not deceleration. This peculiar behavior suggests that tachyons gain energy through these interactions with matter, which in turn accelerates them. The acceleration feedback loop. The heart of tachyonic paradox lies in the feedback loop that ensues when a tachyon loses energy in matter. As it loses energy, it speeds up due to its inherent properties, which intensifies its collisions with atoms, causing further energy loss, and this cycle perpetuates. Astonishingly, it appears that tachyons naturally and seemingly autonomously attain infinite velocity through this perpetual cycle. A key aspect of the theoretical framework surrounding tachyons is their potential to violate causality, the principle that cause precedes effect. Tachyons, if they exist, might challenge this fundamental concept by allowing information to travel back in time. The hypothetical scenario of detecting the effects of a tachyon event before it has occurred raises profound questions about the nature of time and causality. In the modern context, tachyons are often viewed as entities that may have existed at the moment of the Big Bang, the explosive birth of the universe. Their possible role in the early universe may have been pivotal in setting the stage for the expansion of space and the formation of the cosmos. However, it is theorized that tachyons no longer exist in the current universe, providing a potential resolution to the causality dilemma. We will talk a bit later about the tachyons' role in the early universe. It is important to note that tachyons differ significantly from the likes of antimatter and negative matter. Antimatter consists of antiparticles with opposite charge. Antimatter has positive energy and its properties are consistent with the theory of relativity, unlike the tachyons. The antiparticles can annihilate with their corresponding particles, releasing energy in the process. Antimatter particles travel at or below the light speed. They adhere to the principles of special relativity. Now, the negative matter is a theoretical concept with negative energy density, leading to the prediction of anti-gravitational behavior. Negative matter differs from tachyons because it is expected that it would experience repulsive gravity, effectively falling up under gravity, not down. Negative matter, like all known particles and matter, is predicted to travel at or below the light speed. It does not violate the principles of relativity in terms of speed. It is not even clear whether tachyons would fall up or fall down under the influence of gravity. Now, let us look at the profound impact of tachyons on the universe. Tachyons are theorized to destabilize the vacuum, leading to the formation of false vacuum. The concept of vacuum in physics is not an absence of matter, but rather a state of minimum energy. A false vacuum is a state that appears stable, but it is not the lowest energy state that a system can achieve, When tachyons are introduced into a system, they can destabilize the false vacuum, creating a situation where the system is prone to decay. To better grasp the concept of a false vacuum, consider a dam that holds back water in a lake. The dam represents the false vacuum, appearing stable and containing a certain level of energy. However, there exists a lower energy state, similar to the level of water outside the dam at the sea level. A crack would develop in the dam, allowing water to burst through the dam. This symbolizes the emergence of the true vacuum, the lowest energy state. In a similar manner, when tachyons are introduced into a system, they create a situation where the true vacuum has lower energy than the false vacuum. In the context of origin of the universe, it is believed that before the Big Bang, the cosmos existed in a state that is false vacuum. The presence of tachyons in this state indicated that it was not the universe's lowest energy state, making it inherently unstable. As the instability in the false vacuum grew, a tiny rip appeared in the fabric of space-time, marking the transition to the true vacuum. This rip represents the beginning of a cosmic transformation. The rip expanded into a bubble where the conditions inside the bubble differ from those outside. Within this expanding bubble, tachyons ceased to exist while they persisted outside the bubble. The expansion of this true vacuum bubble and the disappearance of tachyons led to the birth of the universe as we know it, marked by the Big Bang. The universe within the bubble, free from the destabilizing influence of tachyons, gradually evolved into the cosmos we observe today. Now, many cosmological models suggest that a specific type of tachyon known as inflation played a vital role in initiating the process of cosmic inflation, which is responsible for universe's rapid expansion in its early stages. Inflation tachyons are thought to have driven the initial phase of expansion, setting the stage for the formation of galaxies and cosmic structures. So basically, tachyons are believed to have destabilized the false vacuum state of the universe, characterized by high energy but was not the universe's lowest energy state. And the presence of tachyons initiated a transformation leading to the formation of tiny bubbles. And inside one of these bubbles, the inflaton field responsible for driving the inflationary period transitioned to the true vacuum state. The true vacuum represents the universe's lowest energy state, and this bubble began to inflate at an astonishing rate, ultimately evolving into what we recognize as our universe. As the bubble universe expanded and evolved into our observable universe, the inflationary phase ceased to exist within this cosmic region. The effects of inflation, which once dominated the early universe, have since dissipated, making it impossible to detect inflationary remnants within our universe. And there goes the tachyons too, no longer observable in the present universe. In this way, the tachyons, which no longer exist within our observable universe, may have shaped various cosmic events. While all this seems like sort of out there stuff, tachyons may be useful in the future. Tachyons may lead to the development of new theories that unify quantum mechanics and general relativity. If the tachyons' potential to travel faster than light could be harnessed, it could revolutionize space travel, allowing for interstellar exploration and travel to distant galaxies within reasonable time frames. However, that is very speculative. And tachyons, by traveling faster than light, could potentially lead to time travel-like scenarios where effects precede their causes, challenging our understanding of causality. Exploring the implications of tachyons for time travel could provide insights into the nature of time itself. Theoretical discussions suggest that tachyons with imaginary mass could be used to generate energy. If harnessed, this energy source could be revolutionary, potentially providing an almost limitless supply of power. tachyons might play a role in quantum computing or communication. If they could be controlled and manipulated, they might enable faster data transmission and processing, overcoming some of the limitations of conventional computing. And as we discussed earlier, tachyons may have played a role in the early universe, particularly during cosmic inflation. Studying their properties and interactions could help refine our understanding of early moments of Big Bang and the subsequent evolution of the cosmos. Tachyons could potentially be used in quantum information theory and quantum entanglement. Their unique properties might enable the development of advanced quantum technologies for secure communication and information processing. Tachyons, with their potential for exotic properties, could be a component of exotic matter needed to stabilize wormholes, hypothetical shortcuts through space-time. This could lead to practical applications for traversable wormholes. It is important to note that tachyons remain highly theoretical and speculative. While their existence could open up new frontiers in physics and technology, their properties and interactions are far from established. And their potential to violate causality and leading to paradoxes introduces significant challenges. I know that researching hypothetical particles like tachyons could be an important endeavor for advancing our understanding of the fundamental laws of the universe. However, I personally believe that focusing on tangible improvements on Earth and the development of VR experiences that can provide direct benefits to humanity should be prioritized more. Thank you very much for watching, and maybe one day generate energy and do quantum computing using tachyons. However, make the Earth utopia first.